Hey, hey, thanks for coming to check out today's video. So today's video is a new crochet tutorial. I am so excited to be doing a crochet video. I feel like it's been forever and yeah, I just want to get a crochet video out here for you guys. It's springtime and I always love wearing my curly hair crochets in the spring. Now I am doing a curl pattern that I've done in the past, but not in this length. This is the Ocean Wave crochet hair 20 inch 8-pack in color T30, and this one is from Toyo Tree. And let me see how much this one goes for. The 20 inch goes for $23, so I'm gonna try to make sure that I use just the one 8-pack because the 8-pack is $23 and it's on Prime. So let me show you what this hair looks like. Really pretty color, lighter brownish blonde at the bottom, but not too abrasive. And then obviously the deep 1B shade at the top. And let's go ahead and cut this off. And they do come pre-looped, so you can just take one piece and loop it in your hair, which is a nice density. It's not too thick. Or you can separate it. But this is what it looks like separated. But yeah, typically I will just leave my crochets unseparated. But yeah, you should get a good amount of hair. This is gonna be probably way more than enough. And for this deal of $23, highly recommend it. I'm going to get started with my crochets, but I wanna show you the braid pattern. So today is absolutely lazy girl crochet. I did not feel like doing a long, drawn out braid pattern. So I literally just did four large braids in the front going straight back. So I parted my hair across the crown and just did one straight part across the crown. I separated out my leave out right here, very very thin amount of leave out, braided that down, and then just did where I want my parts to be. So I always like to have a left side part, a right side part, and a middle part. So I separated where I wanted my parts and then I just did four large braids. Then in the back, I just did three large braids in the back. One, two, three. And now I'm going to get started with the crocheting, and then I will come back with my final thoughts. So I did install the hair using the split method. So I did split each and every piece of hair. And as I got further to the front, I split it even more. This is what three bundles look like. And in the front, I used one full bundle on either side and just a few extra strands at the end. And I'll show you where. When I installed the hair at the front, I used the invisible method and I did use the three knot method. Usually when I'm using hair that has a little more kink to it, I will only use one knot, but this hair is very silky. It's very, very silky and lightweight. So I did use the three knot method. So what you do is you pull one side of the hair through the loop. You hold the loop, twist it one time, twist it another time, and pull the hair through every time, and then tighten the knot. So you have multiple knots on one piece of hair to help hold it in place. I wanted to do a close-up on the hair because these pre-twisted pieces need to be untwisted. So untwist them and then pull them apart, and they will pull apart very soft, very nicely without too much frizzing or knotting up at the ends. So again, this is the lazy girl technique. We do not have that many cornrows, so you do have to, you know, loop the hair through your loose hair. You're not gonna always have a braid to loop the hair through, but you can loop it through the loose hair. It will still hold just as well. So this is what it looks like. Trust the process. We're not done here. We're gonna fill in more of these empty spaces. So I do want to close up my parting space. So usually I will take a small piece of hair from either side of the middle part. I will loop the hair through, pull the hair through 3 times using the invisible knot technique. And then I will close the part. If it's not staying and it's still loose, I take a very thin amount of hair from one side, I loop it around the other side of the hair and knot it again. And that usually helps it stay if you're having trouble with your knots not staying closed. And now for the fun part, I put in little teeny thin pieces of hair. I just loop them regularly and put them all around where the parting space is going to be. That's going to help me to add the frizz and add that more natural invisible look with the brush later on. So these little tiny pieces are literally here just to add some frizz when it's time for me to start the invisible technique. So what I do is grab this brush. This is a very specific brush. It's available in my Amazon store. I don't know what you call it. I call it the scrape your brain away brush. When I do ponytails, this is the brush that I use to slick my ponytails as much as possible. But in this technique, I use this to tease out those thin, tiny little knots that I created of the crochet hair. And this gives you that frayed look that really allows the hair to blend very nicely into, you know, your own hair if you have leave out, or it just blends it into the cornrow braids so you don't see them as much, or the knots either. So there you have it. Pretty much this side is done. I'm going to go ahead and start working on the other side. And then later on in the video, I will release my leave out and blend that as well. So now that all the blending is done, except for my leave out, of course, I don't want to have any scissors near my leave out. I'm going to start giving this hair a haircut. I always say the most important part of your crochet style is the haircut. I truly believe that you can cut corners in so many different areas, but cutting your hair properly will make or break the style. So as you can see by the smile on my face before, I'm loving how this is looking. And now I'm going to go in with some cutting shears. These are from Amazon. I will link them down below. I realized I was cutting my hair and I couldn't see y'all. I did not have my contacts in. And I'm like, ooh, let me not cut my hair while I'm blind. So I grabbed my scissors. I first trim the bottom. I always start trimming those scraggly ends at the bottom. And then I start going in on one side. I'll start to do my face framing layers. And then I will start to separate and pull the pieces apart to see where my layers are going to be. Now, I do have this on a fast speed, but please know that I am taking my time when I do this. I know it doesn't look like this in the video. This part does take a little bit of time. I usually take about 15 to 20 minutes cutting my crochet hair. So please take your time. Don't overcut. Don't, you know, take too much at one time. Just slowly cut the hair because you don't want to ruin your style. And just make sure you're doing what feels best and looks best for your own face shape. This is what I've learned over 15 years of doing my own crochet. This shape works for me. So that is one side done, and you can see the two sides comparatively. It looks so much better when you cut it. So please make sure you cut your crochets. Hey, so I'm back, and this is actually the next day. I put some makeup on, I put my lashes on, I'm rocking this red lip. Oh, and I want to show you guys this dress. I really love this dress. This dress is from Amazon. It is a, let me see if I can scroll out some more. Okay, it is one of those body shapers. So the dress itself is actually a, what do you call it yet? Like a body shaper. So I really love this dress. It has support cups in it. and it just really, really snatches you really nicely. This dress is available on Amazon. I've had this dress for like 2 years now, and I still love it. So I wanted to show you guys this dress. All the jewelry's from Amazon as well. I'll leave it in the description box down below. So this is how the hair came out. I love it. I absolutely love it. And I realized I've used this hair before. I will show you all the video that I used this hair before, but I used it in a 1B. But I'm loving this, especially for spring. It's such a pretty color, T30. I love it. I think it's so, so pretty. So let me take the leave out. Again, I don't even think I need the leave out, to be honest, but I have it, so let me take it out. Okay, so what are we thinking? I think it's cool. I think it's fine. I don't think it's totally necessary. Probably could have definitely did this without any leave out, which I will probably do next time, but still looks good. So I'm gonna do the other side. Okay, here we go, here we go. So that is, that's the end result, you guys. What are we thinking? Are we loving this hair? I'm low-key loving it. I think the cut came out so nice. The layers look really, really good. And the blending is fire. So yeah, I like how this came out. It's crochet, but it's not giving me crochet vibes. I don't know. It's looking real like Brazilian hair, sewing, quick weave or something. Like, it's definitely giving me vibes. It's making me feel like I need to go on vacation. I should be somewhere in Miami or on somebody's beach. I love how this came out. Love how this came out. I guess I should do some baby hairs. Yeah, the baby hairs get the people going. So let me find my edge control. I will lay down my baby hairs and then I will do a little bit of styling of this hair so you all can see what it looks like in different styles. But for me, I'm a bust down middle part type of girl, so I like my middle parts. I do wear side parts as well, so this is able to go into side parts and it's able to do a half up, half down. So I will show you all those styles in a second. All right, so this is the end result with the baby hairs. I think they're cute. I mean, they add a little something to it, but I think it was actually fine without it. But you know, you want to give it that polished look. So here we are. So yeah, this is the hair. I love it. I really, really love it. I think it's great for spring. It looks amazing, very affordable, and yeah, I really love it. So yeah, this is the middle part. And let's switch to a side part. Side part is cute. Side part is definitely cute. Ooh, yes. Okay, side part. A lot of volume. Definitely loving that. Looks very natural. I really like how this came out. Let me take a few pictures and then I'll come back and show you the rest of the stuff. You always look pretty.
Look at me right now, I look crazy.
All right, so now we are going to do the other side part. Cute. I'm really liking this hair. Like, everybody in the house keeps saying how much they like this hair. My husband, my daughter said it's giving Janet Jackson, early 90s. And my husband definitely co-signed that. Then she was like, oh, maybe it's Beyonce. But I'm like, Beyonce would be way, way more blonde than this. So I think maybe we're gonna run this back and try it like in a Beyonce blonde. Cause this is more of like a quiet, like auburn and not necessarily blonde, but I'm loving it. Definitely, definitely loving it. And yeah, I think next time I try it, I don't think I'm gonna do any leave out. I don't think you need leave out with this. It's like unnecessary. You can really get this look without it. So I'm gonna try that next, but I do want to do half up, half down because that is definitely one of my signature styles and it's definitely how I like to wear my crochets. So let's see if we could pull off half up, half down. All right, success. Half up, half down on our crochet. Of course, you can grab your brush and get it a little bit more organized. Definitely cute. Okay, she is versatile. This is definitely versatile and it's the lazy girl style. Like we literally just did what, 5-6 braids and we're eight. Can y'all stop yelling? I'm recording. We literally did about 5 or 6 braids and was able to achieve this look. So it's for my girls out here who can't braid and if you or who aren't that great at braiding. But if you don't want to braid, you could always use the rubber band technique and still achieve this look. Maybe I'll do that next time. I don't know. Leave in the comments any other variations you want to see, either of this color of hair, this type of hairstyle, maybe without braids for those who don't know how to braid. Just leave it in the comments so that I can get some inspiration on what to do next that would be helpful for you all, because I don't want to just be making videos that I like. I want to make videos that are still helpful for you all. And I know I've been out of the loop with my crochets and my quick weaves. That's what you all know and love me for. And I'm gonna get back to it. I have just been so crazy busy. I feel like I'm overdue for a life update. Let me know if you guys even care or wanna see something like that. Otherwise, thank you guys so much for watching, for rocking with me on this channel for so long. Some of you have been here since day one. I think I'm coming up on my 10-year anniversary soon. I think on my birthday, it may be my 10-year anniversary. No, maybe next year would be my 10-year anniversary on YouTube. It's kind of a big deal. I'm kind of excited. I was hoping I would be at 100,000 by now, but I am so, so happy and proud of the 78,000 of you all. So I just appreciate each and every one of you guys. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Do one thing for me, share this video. Share it with a friend, share it with a crochet lover, share this video with your mama. Peace.